Spring will be here in a few weeks. I wanted to close out winter by sharing my favorite items that I actually have been using since December of 2017. So December, January, and February. So first I want to start with a complexion product. This is something that I actually picked up in November at the makeup show. This is by Urban Decay. It's the Naked Skin Shape Shifter. The shade I picked up is medium dark shift. One side is all powder. So you have contour. I use this shade as a bronzer. You have an under eye setting powder. You can also use it to set all over your face. And then you have a powder highlighter, and then you have a mirror. But when you flip it to the other side, so you just have the mirror, which is the divider, you turn it and then you have it same, but you have the cream product. If you're someone that prefers powders, if you're someone that prefers creams, or you want to interchange and work with both of them at the same time, the convenience of having it all in one compact is a good selling point. So I've been getting a lot of use out of this. Also, I don't know for the new year if this item is going to be leaving as far as a lot in the Urban Decay lineup, because I received an email from Ulta and this shapeshifter is now 50% off. As a consumer, at 50% off, you're actually getting more than at pro price. So if this is something you want, go to Ulta and pick it up in the stores, or you can order it online. This next item I have been using on and off for several years. This is from Coty. It's the Coty Airspun Loose Powder. Now this is in the shade Naturally Neutral. This is the only shade that I will use. I won't use any other shade. This one is, I feel, truly colorless. It just melts into the skin. I don't even probably have to give a formal review, because it has, there's so many write-ups on it. There's so many videos on it. It's just, it's been around. This powder has been around since 1925. Now I know it says on the package 1935, but it actually was created in 1925. However, the machine that actually was created for the powder, where I guess, and it's not being too technical, picture throwing all the ingredients into the machine, and then it is doing its air spun and spinning and doing everything inside that machine. So the ingredients for the powder, it was created and it actually spun it and did everything in 1935. I can use it with a dry sponge. I can use it with a wet sponge. I can use it with a brush. I can use it with a puff. It just works with lots of different tools. It works with a majority of foundation. It sets the foundation, it sets the concealer. You can just wear it alone if you like. You don't wear base makeup. It's a powder that is very versatile, and it's a powder that works. So it has, you know, it's been around for so long, to be honest, for a reason. And it's a really great powder and a great addition. And I just noticed that ever since I started to kind of organize my categories for my makeup, and this is front and center, I do have it separated drugstore and high end. And this is just something that I constantly now, I'm reaching for it and I'm actually enjoying it too. Now it has a smell. This is not the scented, unscented version. There is fragrance free versions of it. I have never seen them in the stores. I don't know if it's something that is really only in certain stores, maybe in certain states, certain cities. I'm not too certain, but I could pick it up at any drugstore, but I'm okay. The scent isn't anything that's too alarming to me. It doesn't linger on my skin. I put it on and I'm done. It's nothing for me to be alarmed about, but it is a great powder. If you haven't tried it, I definitely recommend it. And, you know, if you are my skin tone, even deeper, Naturally Neutral, I feel, is definitely the shade to go. Next, I have two eyeshadow palettes. Now, I can honestly say for 2017, when I go back and I think about the palettes, the ones that I was kind of staring at a lot was Too Faced. Go figure. Well, I say that for myself, because some years I have it where I don't pay them any attention, and then I have some years that, you know, Too Faced just seems to be knowing what they're doing. And I feel for 2017, they did it right with these two palettes. So I'm gonna first talk about candies. Candies. Johnson, this is I Want Candy from Too Faced, and it's her collaboration with the brand. Packaging for this is just, it's absolutely adorable. I mean, with the little pieces of candy in the back with the names of all of the eyeshadows inside. This was the sticker for the palette. The main reason why I kept reaching for this palette is it has everything in here that I felt that I can do an eye look, even down to the brow bone shade. These two shades down here, banana cream and ice cream, I can use those interchange, set my primer, set my brow bone, I'm good to go. Then you have these little box sections here of the different shades. So if you want to do something that's warm that day, you can do that. If you want to do something that's cooler, you can do that. I wanted something a little bit more smokier, so I did this quad right here. And there's shades that complement in between, so you can use those to build up your eyeshadows, which is the type of user I am when it comes to eyeshadow. So there's just everything in here. I can just take this palette, if that's the only one I want to take with me, say I travel, then that's what I can do. So that's something that I've been enjoying. Same thing with the Just Peachy mattes. Now, this one took a while for me to not only play with in the store, but also to pick up. I believe this is a Sephora exclusive. Yes, because it's part of the Peachy collection, which is only at Sephora. There are so many shades in here that I can use to build up my eyeshadows. That's what I love. So I have my brow bone shades right here, so I can go to town with that. I have this shade as well. So I focus this side here mainly to set my primer, do my brow bone shade. And then the other shades I use a lot of times just to build up in colors. I'll use it either with, like I did with this eye look today using the candy palette, I used a few of these shades here, but I also use it with whatever palette just happens to be sitting on the desk as well. So it works great by itself. It works great with other shadows. It does smell like peach, which isn't alarming to me. I think it has a pleasant smell. It's not a formula that I've noticed where it irritates my eyes, where I broke out or anything. So usually with Too Faced powder shadows, I don't have any type of allergic reaction. This compact has a mirror, VIB. Now I just remembered when I got it. I did receive it at the VIB, so I waited in to use my discount. But it is a great palette, and it just blends so well. That's what I enjoy about it. I can just keep packing it on, and it blends and it moves wherever I want it to go. So loving this. Next up are lip products, and these are from Too Faced as well. Now I have three of their melted matte lipsticks. This is in their tube formula. This is kind of like the their melted tube formula. That's actually the ones I really enjoy, and I have a ton of them in my lipstick collection. But what got me to love these is the candy collection. Because I had the one that's called Freshly Baked. So it's this one right here, and it's the lipstick that I have on. And okay, I'm gonna tell you something. When it comes to liquid lipsticks aren't something that I tend to gravitate towards, and it's not something that I have to have it. One, I actually enjoy reapplying my lipstick throughout the day. I am one of those people. You know, their purpose is not to be applying it all day long. So the way it wears throughout the day, I pay a lot of attention to it. I want to make sure that it's not overly dry. I don't want it to look overly dry. That's something I don't like, period, for my makeup. I just don't want to look dry all over. And I want it to feel comfortable, but not, know when it starts to wear off. You can have like little pieces and it's peeling and it's cracking. It's just looking a mess. And by then you probably can't even notice it. You're not even looking in the mirror. And then it's like people are seeing that. I've had those situations. But with the Too Faced melted mattes, this is so comfortable. It allows me enough time to put it on. It then starts to dry. If I want to put a lip liner on like I did for today, I pair this with Cork, I pair it with MAC Whirl, and it just melts in with whatever lip liner you just happen to put on. And it just dries and then it's on. I can be drinking water throughout the day. I can be doing whatever, talking, smiling, laughing. It tends to stay put. Now it can stay on until I'm about ready to take it off at night, but even when it's time to take it off, it doesn't look horrible. And I can also reapply it. Let's say if I had a salad for lunch, I can reapply it and it still looks like freshly applied, like how I would have done it in the morning. So it's not where my lips are so thirsty for moisture and it's just ruined the condition of my natural lips. I am very much impressed with this formula. Now, this small one was in a Christmas box that I had received for a Christmas gift. So this is a small one and this is sellout. So I have worn this one and they do actually look a bit similar, the shades. So one is a little bit more brown based, but I really do enjoy those as far as my nude. And then around Christmas time, I picked up one. I even wore this one in a video. I get compliments all the time when I wear this color, and this is Lady Balls. This is a beautiful blue-based red. It is just gorgeous. I don't believe it's limited edition. It's a beautiful color. You can wear year-round. You only don't have to use it, of course, for Christmas. It's absolutely beautiful. I would love to have all the colors, but I'm going to refrain from going crazy, but I'm happy with those three. I can interchange them in my collection and really create some beautiful lips, but it's the formula that I enjoy and the wear time, and it just looks great. So they did a great job on the melted mattes and definitely is a liquid lipstick formula that I recommend. The next lip product is a gloss. This is from Anastasia Beverly Hills. Now I picked this up from my local Marshalls. A lot of Anastasia products are over there on sale. This is in the shade Potion. This is actually my first time trying the lip gloss. I am not a lip gloss person to the extent of I go out and I am like, I have to have that lip gloss or I'm wearing it 24/7. I am more of a lipstick girl, like a lipstick tube or stick, whatnot. This is actually my first lip gloss from them that I've ever used. I haven't tried their lip glosses. I have enough lip gloss to the point it's not something I'm going to run out and pick up. But I picked it up because it was so inexpensive, and I think it was like $6, to be honest. And I love a deep, vampy color. I'm impressed with this lip gloss formula because it mimics a lipstick. This is a lip gloss that is so opaque that it doesn't even look like a lip gloss. When you think of a lip gloss, or when I think of a lip gloss, sometimes it's just something that's very sheer, something to add some shine to the lips. This looks like a lipstick that has a lip gloss on top that's opaque. That's exactly the type of formula. So I was quite impressed when I wore this. I'm like, whoa, this just looks like a shiny lipstick. A 2-in-1, which is so easy. You just swipe it on, perfect it, done. Now, it doesn't last all day. It's not meant to last all day, and that's not something I'm even looking for in my lip glosses. It's beautiful. I love it. I love how bigger my lips look with it on, and it's something I definitely am enjoying, and it is something that I recommend. And the last item I have is a spray mist. Now, this is from e.l.f. It's their Active Post-Workout Cool Down Mist. I saved the packaging. Now I can finally toss it after I make this video. Let's have a cap, which I tend to leave off because I don't like caps. I just want to spray and go. But this is something, it's part of their workout line. I picked this up with their black eyeliner. And the eyeliner is supposed to stay in the waterline. That's my goal, is to find something rich and dark and black, like tar black, stay in the waterline and will not bleed. It bled and it went right back to the store. But this stayed. And the reason why this stayed is it's very refreshing. It has a refreshing scent. It's not like cucumber or anything that's too distinct, but it has a very pleasant scent. On the back of the box, it states that it's a refreshing facial mist. It nourishes the skin with replenishing ingredients. It helps you cool down after your workout. So use it to set, you can use it to set your makeup or set and hydrate and maintain that just got out of yoga glow. I do yoga and I don't really have a yoga glow, but that's what it says. The breathable performance formula is sweat resistant and won't clog your pores to keep up with your active beauty lover. The first ingredient I was looking for was to see if there was any coconut up at the top because I can't have that. There's no coconut. There's the ingredients at the top are meant to attract the water and then keep you hydrated. I've been using it as it's just rotating throughout my sprays, like my hydrating sprays. I'll use it sometimes before I put on a primer. Anytime it feels like my skin is feeling extra dry, I will spray it on. I spray it on the beauty sponge and then apply the foundation. As far as to set the makeup and it being long lasting throughout the day, it's not something that I've seen for that. So what I will do is at the end of the makeup application, I'll spray it, but then I spray my setting spray on top of it. And again, it's for me, it's working well as hydration. I want to say I paid $8 for this. It might have been maybe a dollar or two less. I also like the sleek design of this bottle, how small it is. I mean, it actually looks bigger than it's only 2.7 ounces. I mean, this is something you can take on a plane with you and they're not going to take it from you. So for the hydration benefits alone, I think it's been working great. And again, just rotating it into my daily makeup application. And that's it. That closes out winter for me. All of these items have definitely been capturing my heart, December, January, as well as February. I would love to know if you've been using any of these items. Do you have them? What have been your favorites? Not only for winter, what favorites have you been using during this current month as well? It's fun to share and find out, you know, what is everybody keeping on their desk and getting a lot of use out of. Don't forget, 50% off at Ulta, if that is something that you are looking for, the Shapeshifter. So I do want to thank you for stopping by and watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day or evening. And as always, I'm going to see you in the next video. Bye, everyone.